All right, so here we are in another campus in this series of Know Your Campus, and today we are at a campus which is known for its greenery, which is known for its inclusiveness, which is known for its people. And right now I'm standing right next to this huge chime, which maybe is the longest and the highest chime I've ever seen in my life. And to talk more about this and a lot more about this institute that we are going to cover in this episode of KYC, I have here Srishti and I have with me Piyush. Both of them are second year students, and welcome to KYC, and thank you very much for inviting us over to Edmo. With the kind of nature that I saw, with the kind of area that I saw, with the kind of birds, animals that I saw, it felt like a park to me. What sort of campus is this? How big exactly is this? And how is the life around this?
So it's a 60-acre green lush campus. So I'll tell you basically how my typical day in the campus is like. So I wake up at 9 a.m. I have my breakfast, and then I have classes starting up right then. So after that, you go to the mess, you have the evening snacks and tea, and then you can see people actually playing in this big playground, either football or cricket or tennis or volleyball, basketball. We also have a student activity center. We have things like badminton, pool, table tennis, and a gymnasium as well. So after that, there are, 10 clubs in Irma of varied topics. Like there is Nishadya, the marketing club. There is Abhyudaya, the policy club. There is IDCC, the development consultancy club. So students actually devote their times in engaging on different current issues, topics. And after that, it's time to finally prepare for those odd quizzes which we have daily and preparing for the assignments. And then you have your dinner.
And we have 15 hostel blocks which have around more than 500 individual occupancy rooms.
Just quickly, if you can tell me the kind of courses that are offered here what is the intake for each of the batches you're looking at?
So the flagship program at IRMA is PGDM-RM, which has 252 students. Apart from that, we also have two more courses. One is a fellowship program in the field of rural management and executive program for rural management.
Right. What is the kind of fees that we're looking at?
So the fees for the flagship PGDM-RM program stands at 15.6 lakhs. But one thing which I really like about this program is that there are more than 80 scholarships available for all the students, which amounts to 3 crores rupees. So that is very unique to IRMA, which you can never find in other B schools. And that is one thing that I really am proud of.
Absolutely. It's fading light here. We have been exploring this campus for long today, and I would like to explore a little bit more.
Definitely.
I've heard that you guys have a fascinating nightlife here also.
Yes.
Let's have a quick refresher. Let's go around the campus, see through some of the nooks and corners that we maybe have missed. So let's go. Okay guys, so we were talking about the courses and the fees, and what better place to talk a little bit more about what this course actually holds than this classrooms where you guys possibly spend most of your days. Let's talk a little bit more about the kind of programs that you have and what exactly you guys study.
So basically the entire pedagogy of IRMA is designed in a way that the courses, the subjects which we study are divided in 3 parts. The first part is called the foundation part, in which we study different subjects which lays the foundation of basic management principles like accounts, microeconomics. Apart from that, we study subjects like rural society and polity, collective action, which imbibes in us the basic understanding of ruralities of our country. So we use this learning and put it into 8 weeks rural immersion program, which is called Village Fieldwork Segment. Then the second part of our course is called the functional subjects in which we study subjects like marketing, communications, financial management, public policy analysis, and use our entire learning and use the skills which we have learned in the classroom for a 2-month summer internship segment, which we do with various reputed industries or various domains. And the third part of our entire curriculum is called interactive intermediary, in which we build upon our existing knowledge base with various optional subjects like blockchain technology, machine learning, and try to contextualize whatever we have learned to make it use for the corporates and the rural enterprises.
Let's talk a little bit more about one thing that people absolutely look for when they're looking for B schools, and that is the rankings and accreditation. So about IRMA, what are the kind of accreditations that this institute holds, and what are the rankings like?
So if you talk about on papers, IRMA is NAC A accredited institute, and NIRF ranks us at 55th position. But for the students who are studying here, IRMA is not an option but a conscious choice which they make, because the existing ranking systems are not designed such that they are able to measure what IRMA has to offer as an institute, because apart from conventional management studies, there are various aspects to IRMA. Like, we have a special social entrepreneurship incubation center, we have Center for Excellence, the professors who are working are also working as independent consultants, they are working in designing the policies. The kind of subjects which we are offered are quite different from the conventional B schools. So these things are not included in the ranking. But apart from that, the entire pedigree of IRMA managers are such that they consciously want to study at this institute, and they are a very good mix of heart and head kind of decision makers.
There is a lot more that you want to cover in this particular episode, but before that, it's after hours, it's evening, and I'm sure after the class ends, you guys go chill, you guys go play, and I am a person who likes to play. So it will be great if you guys can take me some place where I can, flex my muscles a little and give you guys a competition.
Definitely. Let's
go.
Let's check it out.
Alright, so here we are in this buzzing space where we can see, a lot of these players playing badminton, a lot of these people playing table tennis and whatnot. And, this place itself is giving me a lot of energy. Further our talk where we left, let's talk a bit about the kind of alumni members that you guys have. You guys spoke about them, a few of them definitely. Tell me a little bit more about, who are the kind of people who have been part of the legacy of IRMA.
So IRMA has a 42-year-long legacy, and that's why we have created 4,000 rural managers. So I'll talk about them in decades. So in the first decade, which is in the first 10 years, we have notable alumni like Dr. R.S. Sodhi sir, who is the managing director of Gujarat Cooperative Milk Marketing Federation. We also have Shivakumar sir, who created ITC eChoppal, which is the world's biggest digital rural marketplace. Talking about the second decade of IRMA, we have Usha Mishra ma'am, who works in UNICEF Nepal. We also have Neeraj Kumar sir, who works in Colgate-Palmolive. We also have Mamta Murthy ma'am. And talking about the third decade, we have Shefali Vijayvargiya ma'am. And she is a brand manager of Amul Cool. And then she was in 2020's Forbes 30 and the 30 India's list. So, we have a diverse range of alumni in all diverse kinds of fields. And for one special thing is that for these alumni, we have the annual alumni reunion event, which is called as Milap. And we name it in different terms, like we have it 10 saal baad, 20 saal baad, 30 saal baad and 40 saal baad. So that is one thing which is very, very special about our alumni interconnectedness, which is in this big IRMA family.
Lovely. So on this particular portion, what we usually do for KYC is we ask people about if there are any student exchange programs, but I've heard that you guys have a special program. So I really want to know a little bit more about that particular program, if you can tell me.
Yeah, like, we do not have any student exchange program, but out of 6 terms, we have 2 on-field terms. One is summer internship and another is very unique to the entire IRMA pedagogy, which is called village fieldwork segment. So this is an 8-week long term in which the students are expected to work as an intern with various rural development organizations like URMUL, NDDB, BEF, and we go to the rural villages. And what we have to do is first identify the existing strength of the entire rural community, and second, use those strengths and enable those rural communities to solve their current problems.
Okay, so now we have come to the portion in this particular video which a lot of these students really look forward to and wait for, which is the placements and the kind of salaries and the kind of companies that come on campus. So tell us a little bit about all of these that I spoke about that really excites our audience.
Yes, so we have various sectors of company. We have agribusiness and rural marketing companies coming up. We have collectives and cooperatives, which we have government and non-government consultancy, development organizations, tech organizations, IT and systems. We have BFSI organizations as well. At IRMA, you get to choose from a diverse range of offers. And talking about the placement figures of 2021, for 216 students, so 2021 was the COVID period. We had the second wave of COVID hitting us. So even in COVID period, for 216 students, there were 336 offers by more than 126 organizations. So if you see, each student gets more than one offer to choose from. And pre-COVID times, it was like close to two offers that each student could choose from. And talking about the median salary that each student gets, it stands at 10.2 lakhs per annum. And then for the summer internship segment, the median stipend stands at ₹58,000. Yeah, so that is the kind of placements. But this year the placements are like improving, the market is improving and the companies are paying us better and we are getting bigger packages compared to the previous years.
The last thing that I would like you guys to discuss about is the kind of admission process that you guys have. How do I actually get in this particular institute if I have?
So if you are a student and you want to come to IRMA, you first need to go through the admission form, you need to apply for it. Then after your CAT scores, once you are shortlisted for IRMA, you either choose for an online interview or an offline interview, and then you have to appear for group discussion, a written ability test, and finally a personal interview. And lastly, you will get a call from IRMA if you are finally shortlisted.
So as we all know that Dr. Varghese Kurian, who was the founder of IRMA, he gave 10 principles, and the ninth of it was to create more Kurians who use the instrument of cooperative structure to bring change not in milk but other industries. So this is a very great opportunity for all of the students who want to join IRMA and learn transformative management and be part of this Kurian legacy.
Absolutely. On that note, thank you very much, Srishti. Thank you very much, Piyush, for giving us a guided tour of this particular institute. I really enjoyed my time here at IRMA, and I will not hold you guys back anymore. I will let you guys go join your friends and play the game. If you wish to know more about this particular institute, there is a link in the description below. You guys can go check that out, and do tell us in the comments below if you want anything more that we cover on KYC, and we will come up with them in the next episodes of KYC. Thank you.